let's get started. If you want to build a new page for your website with the Elementor free version, you can easily do that. Here is a website in a WordPress, and I already have the Elementor plugin installed, so I don't have to install it, but I'm just going to show you how you can do it too. So you'll have to go to plugins. You can find it on the left side menu and click add new. Here you will have to search for the Elementor, and you will see install now button, which you'll have to click to install it. I don't see that button because it's already installed and it just requires an update, so that's why we can see update now. After you install the Elementor, you can go to pages and click add new, so that's where you can create a new page for your website. Here you can name your page, so we're going to name it Elementor Tutorial and save draft so we don't lose it, and click edit with Elementor. Okay, so that's how the page is looking now. We can see my existing header for my website and the sidebar. We can disregard it now because we're going to build this center content right here. And we have three options right here. We can create everything from scratch by just clicking on this plus first and selecting the structure type, and after drag and drop from the left side. Or we can upload our own templates right here if we have them already and want to use it here. Or the last option is that we can just select existing template from this list. Here we can filter by new, by trend, by popular. If we see pro icon, that means it's not free, it's for a paid version, so we can disregard it. For our tutorial, we're going to select something simple and free. So let's select this one. We have to insert it. Yes. Let's wait a little bit while it's loading. Okay, so that's how it looks right now. It's pretty long and there's so much content. So we're gonna get rid of most of these blocks and just edit some of them. Okay, let's get started. Let's say I want to remove this. I just click on it, click on X, and boom, it's done. Let's remove more sections. We don't need this, 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 and let's leave this for now. Okay, here I want to change some text, so I click here on the left and change the text to something else. There we go. We change the text. We're going to change the sizing to something smaller. For some reason it's not changing right now. Let's change the layout a little bit. So I want to make it a little bit more wide. I don't want to have this, so I right click on my mouse and I click delete. So they get rid of the image. I also don't really want this section, so I also click here on delete. So we got rid of this. If I click on this icon, we see another layout menu we can also use, but right now we don't need it. And basically, I don't want to have this at all, so I click more to delete. And now what I want to do is I want to add another section right here. So I click on last. And I want to just have this block. So I would like to add the image right here. I click on this plus and I drag and drop this image from the left menu. Now we can see this. I want to change the size to medium. If I had a link, I could add a link so my image would be clickable, but I don't have a link right now, so I'm just going to add the image. I'm going to select the image from this media library. These were automatically moved here from the template we just inserted. So let's add this image. Also, we can add alt text right here in title. I'm just gonna name it beer. So if you add this, it can be more easily found if people search for the keyword you used. And that's how this looks like. So we're gonna leave it as is. Now I want to make some changes right here. So here I want to get rid some of the text. Same here. I don't like this icon, so I'm gonna delete it. Same here. I'm gonna leave the same titles for now and get rid of this ugly small icons or whatever that all the shapes. Okay, much better. I'm gonna get rid of part of a text right here too. Okay. Same here. Same here. Okay, now it looks much better. And also I want to change the header to smaller size. Okay, for some reason it's not changing, but it should. Okay, we can leave it as is right now, no big deal. So let's see what we have here. So here we're gonna have more menu if you click on this style icon, and here I want to change the color of the text. So I'm going to change it to something nicer. For example, this one, I'm fine with that. Here we can add some shadow if you want, but we don't. Well, it looks nice actually, so we can leave it. Let's go back to this and we can reposition the text so it's more centered. We can get rid of this and delete this section, and yeah, looks much better. So here I want to add some gradient right here. Here we can select more settings. We can change the height, the width, whatever options we have here. And okay, this was removed. I think I accidentally removed this. If you hover on this eye icon, you can see all your changes if you set them before. And here you can make them more responsive. You can see again the whole history right here. So if I click on the icon, we can see what I edited. So it's a nice place to check if, let's say, you think you removed something by accident, so you want to see what exactly, when. And here you can see what revisions were done. And go back here. So that's how our, let's make it bigger actually, that's how our page going to look like right now. And we already previewed it, but let's click on this preview icon. It's gonna open the new tab with the same design we just did. Before we publish, we can review it to see if everything looks good. If not, we can make additional edits. If we're happy, we can just publish. So we're gonna wait a little bit while all content is loaded. So here we can see how it looks, pretty nice. For this simple design tutorial. You might want to play around with reducing some spacing right here if you don't need them. And here, in order to go back to the previous page, you just have to click on X on the open top. So it's closed that. And here, so basically here you can also add more content if you want. You still have a space right here, and that's it. So if we're happy now, we can publish. Also here you see a few more options: save as draft and save as template. If you save as a template, it is saved on the template library. You can reuse later for other purposes, for new pages. And if I click publish, it's going to be published. And it basically looks exactly the same as the cell on a preview. We have this extra space because we didn't have any other blocks. If we would have the more blocks right here, it would be more full. So for now, it's totally okay. So here you can see the whole page we just built. And basically, if you wonder where it's going to be published, it will be published where you want it to be. You will also always have to add the new page to your existing menu. So for example, right now I did not add it to any other menus right here, so we won't be able to see this under any tab. But in case I want to do that, what I'll have to do is, I'm going to show you right now, I'll have to go to appearance, my menu. So here is my main menu, and here I click view all, and I select the page we just created. So it's going to be Elementor tutorial. So I check this box, I add it to the menu. I'm not going to do that now because I don't need this page to be appeared there, but that's what you do. You click to add menu and you reposition this tab. So you add this to whatever main category you want or as a separate tab, and click save menu. And after that, you will either see it as a separate tab or under any other specific section somewhere right here. And that's it. I hope this tutorial was helpful for you, and thank you for watching.